I make the world graphical.
I add value through my products.
I am an animator.
I am a filmmaker. I develop trends.
I transform designs to reality.
I create environments.
I translate stories to furniture.
I design experiences.
I'm an immersive media designer.
I design mobility.
This is not only a design institute.
This is a design lab.
Join us in our design movement.
Hello, a very good afternoon to all of you. I welcome you to the 5th edition of MIT ID webinar. I am Harshit Desai and I am the lead faculty for the design management program here at MIT ID. And today here I am with Mr. Kiran Sabnis, who is a very experienced professional from the design industry and has a wide experience across multiple industries and multiple companies. More than that, I think he's one of the best mentors that somebody can have in today's time. And we are very fortunate that he's joined us today for this discussion on MIT ID design management program. So thank you, sir, for joining, and we welcome you for the
session. Thank you, Harshit. It's really amazing for providing this opportunity to me. And I'm sure we'll address all the, we'll provide maximum possible information in the given time and also take some questions. So the students who are really committed and passionate for making career in design management today will benefit out of it.
Yeah. So, sir, these are very interesting times for design as a profession in our country, and we have seen that how design is kind of emerging as a profession, and as it grows, there are different areas that are opening up for designers. So, how do you see this whole role of design management as a area of study, and especially from the industry point of view? How do you see this area of design management per se?
Okay, this is a very, very interesting topic to start this conversation. Basically, design management, if we look at the larger canvas, at one side there is a design and another side it's a management.
True.
And what currently industry is demanding is not only skills or only designers who can play with the tools and techniques. On the other hand, industry is looking out for some Generation Z kind of a designers who understand the business, the strategy, the management, the social context, the bigger ecosystem of the stakeholders, as well as design, who would be understanding user-centric thinking. So, in last 10 years, Harshit, if we see, the industry is moving from a typical commodity to product, to solutions, to services. Now it's a world of experience economy.
Experience,
right? And in experience economy, design management plays extremely important role, because design is no more a siloed function in the larger corporates or even a startup. Design is always an integral part of management ecosystem.
Interesting.
So it's a very right time for me to make career in design management.
Fantastic. No, I think that was the whole reason for us also to kind of start this program in design management, because there are other specializations as well where people can specialize in a particular discipline of design. But when it comes to, say, design management, who can benefit, or who should apply for such a program? Means who is it meant for? Or if I have to put it in other words, what is that somebody needs to become a design management person?
Right. So I'm looking at from two perspectives. One is assuming that I am MIT, okay?
Fair enough.
And I want to select the right kind of person who would come and get mentored in MIT for design management course. And secondly, I look at it from industry perspective. Okay, I want to recruit a guy.
Okay.
So there are two things, you know. In MIT perspective, you guys are expert, but I would look out for a person who has got appropriate thought process in terms of creative thinking, analytical abilities, and also who is proactive and typical dynamic learner. Harshit, this is very important aspect of today's life, you know. Mm-hmm. Dynamic learning, because today's tools are no more appropriate for tomorrow. And design management, design is changing at a very rapid pace. Technology is moving at a very rapid pace. And management, though fundas are appropriate or similar, you know, they are also changing. Mm-hmm. So I will look out for a person who is willing to learn, who is willing to change his abilities quickly, who is creative, passionate, proactive. So this is what I would look out while we induct the person at MIT. I'm not very, you can put light on that, but I'm not stuck with whether the person has done interior design or BE mechanical or BTech electronics or so on and so forth, you know. Okay. Even a wonderful BCom guy, I don't know the eligibility criteria, but I as a person would go for it. But once he goes through your design management program, and I have gone through that into amazing modules, and we'll discuss more on that. But I would be looking out for a person in an industry, one who knows about management tools and techniques, at least getting sensitized for that. Looking out for an MBA guy, you know, who knows a lot of things about, but one who has understood management principles. Two, who has got fair understanding of technology landscape. Hmm. One who knows, again, I'm not looking out for an expert who has done work in Python and so on and so forth, but I'm looking out for a person who understands the changing technology paradigms, and also most important is who is designer at heart.
Hmm. Okay.
So who is designer at heart with a human-centric approach plus management fundas and technology understanding. Fourth, I know that I'm expecting more, but fourth, who is socially conscious person. So these four blockers, technology, design, management sensitivity, and socially conscious person, any industry can pick that guy.
Interesting. So so for us also, I think that's what we have kept it very broad-based. Mm-hmm. So in terms of eligibility criteria, as you rightly mentioned, it is meant for any graduate.
Okay.
It doesn't matter as to what background they come from.
Okay.
But yeah, a basic interest in design, and as you rightly said, that attitude of problem solving and making things better for a human experience point of view, there are ways to kind of find out and test this capability. So that becomes one of the criteria for us to kind of let somebody in. And yeah, there are other domain related things, so people may come from an engineering background or from a commerce background, but I think what happens in the classroom, that there's a lot of peer learning which is also happening.
Absolutely.
So people coming from different backgrounds, people coming from different experiences is what we actually seek in the cohort. So there is an opportunity for them to learn from each other, and I think in today's world that's one of the best ways of learning. I think we spend some time on kind of segregating that how much percentage will eventually be taught and how much people have to learn. Could you just elaborate on that as well, and how do you see that getting applied on this program?
Yeah, I think if I draw a triangle, or if I draw a pyramid, the top 10% would be mentored by the faculty in any design school. Let's be very clear, guys. That 10% will be mentored by the faculty, 40% is what peer learning, and that's what Harshit is talking about, the peers, multidisciplinary peers, you know. And if you guys are lucky if you get engineers, psychologists, behavior economists, or commerce graduate guys, or even literature and business guys, you know, who has done BBA, perhaps that could be enormous help. So 40% is peer learning, and 50% is self-learning. So we should be very clear, and even industry demands that, you know. So the person who learns on her own would be absorbed very quickly. So mantra is 10, 40, 50. 10% mentors, 40%
peers,
and 50% you need to learn on your own. And just to add to what Harshit sir is talking about is, in this design management program, you know, so what I have gone through that, and thanks for providing some information to me, is it's the pedagogy that you guys are following is like 10, it's more about self-exploration, peer learning, and ambient learning. The people who actually go in the social context, they go into the industries and do their projects.
Sure.
So that way, you know, so that could be the right mix of the people, and industry can absorb them pretty good.
So yeah, I mean, that is one of the, that's the feature of all the MIT ID programs, and especially in the design management program, there is a lot of industry intervention when the classrooms is, sessions are even happening.
Right.
In fact, a lot of faculty and including you, they come from a background where they themselves are either professionals in industry or consultants or who are in the space of design management. So the classroom learning itself is a live experience while they are in the classroom. So, and plus there are other internships, there is a longer project, and there are other live projects which they take up during the program. I think that that makes them even ready before they actually enter into the industry.
So right.
That's how the course structure also has been designed. So I think if there are any questions, we would like to start with that and kind of help students understand some more specific details that they are having. So yeah, the first question is from Sailesh, and he's asking, can you provide an overview about MDes in the design management program? Yeah, so we briefly spoke about it, but to give you an overview, you can visualize this syllabus of the program into two aspects. One is on the design, and the other component is of business. So under design, you will be exposed to, like as sir was mentioning, the methods, processes, and the attitude of how do you kind of look at something from a designer's point of view. So you may not get trained on design per se, but you get all those required skills and mindset which is required to solve a problem or map an opportunity from a design point of view. And it happens through different courses which are spread across the semester, right from user research to prototyping to service design to other aspects which are coming from the design side of things. The other component is purely on the business models part of it, where everything and anything that we do in today's world needs to have a business case. So how do I understand that business case? How do I understand the business environment? How do I see that how technology is creating new opportunities, creating new industries in itself? And that understanding of business, the content which you get exposed to. In terms of specific courses, we have some interesting modules which are part of the program. Mm-hmm. One is kind of giving the exposure to the experience economy. So we may call it in terms of the what happens in the digital side of things, but there is a good amount of exposure when it comes to you solving a problem and creating a user experience. So that always gets connected to the design and the business angle, and how do I create the right kind of experience, be it digital, be it physical, be it hybrid. So that set of input is given under a module. Another module is on service design, where we see a lot of work happening, especially from the service industry, and wherever there is an input on digital transformation and these kind of things. So that gets covered under service design. And one of the interesting modules again is on design futures, where I'm not just looking at what's happening now, but I'm able to project some things in future and create possibilities for what's happening in the near future. So there's some interesting modules which have been created, and they are nicely kind of dovetailed into the larger set of modules that we have.
So if you may give me, can I give an example?
Yeah,
of
please,
that,
please.
You know?
Sir, yeah.
So guys, let's try to demystify what Harshit sir talked about. You know, so assume that Harilal runs a vada pav shop in Matheran, okay, which is a hill station near Mumbai and Pune in Maharashtra. So Harilal has been selling this vada pav for years and ages, and now Harilal is say 60, 70 years old. And Harilal does business, and tens of thousands of customers come to Mahabaleshwar and Matheran, and they have awesome steamy hot vada pav. But Harilal's son, Hitesh, comes and joins Harilal's business, and Hitesh is a new age, new generation person. Now, how design management graduate, MDes in design management can help Harilal and Hitesh is what we will be teaching you over here. So, what should be the business strategy? So, Harilal's Vada Pav goes to Dubai and San Jose and London. So, what should be the positioning? What should be the marketing strategy? What should be the campaigning strategy? What technology platforms he should be exposing? What kind of a packaging and what kind of a shape of Vada Pav? From that, you know, so what would be the forecasting? What sir was talking about? What would be the future of Harilal's Vada Pav in 2040, 2050? So, a small, simple example, a design management guy who is talking about service design, futures, technology platform, social impact. For example, if Harilal designs some packaging, will it be socially appropriate? You know, will it be a sustainable packaging? Can it be made locally? And Harilal's son, Hitesh, wants to have global franchisee. So it's like there are so many stakeholders. It's a fairly wicked problem, complexity, stakeholder communications, value equations. So this is a simple thing, but the moment you expand that, so this all will be covered into design management program.
Very nicely put, sir. I think that really helps everybody understand the basics. And as you said, once the basics are clear, whether I'm applying it to a Vada Pav stall or whether I'm applying Absolutely. To an MNC or applying to an automotive, I think that's the focus of the program, that we will kind of train you on the fundamentals, and then where do you apply and what do you make use of that knowledge that you have gained is up to you. So that lot of other factors of what's your background, what is your aspiration, all of that is what will guide you on that. And which brings me to this next question, where it is asking applicability of this course in today's changing design market. So again, at one end there are, say, designers who are doing a task, and at the end one end there are management or MBA grads who are doing a class. Where does this fit into from a industry point of view?
I think it's a fabric. It's a bridge that connects typical hardcore designers as a pillars,
okay,
and management MBAs and Whartons and IIMs grads, you know. So this guy would be a bridge between these two, and it does not mean that he will be only talking about that. For example, if we catch hold of any of the designers, since I am designer, and if I meet any of the designers who is working in a typical company, if I ask, hey, how did you design, say, this new application for, say, Watchman? I'm purposely taking a very day-to-day examples, you know. So, how did you come up with this application for a student?
Then Food he will say,
then he will say that, okay, sir, I got the requirements from product management team and this and that. This guy would be the bridge between the management and this.
Design.
He would be proactively talking with the sales guys, franchisee guys, channel partners, management, CXOs, CFOs, and Harshit, it's not easy to talk with these guys unless you understand their language
and their
designers.
Mindset.
Again, I'm not comparing any of the design specializations, but this specialization understands the language of management. Other designers may or may not. They will eventually learn this language over the experience. But here they are taught the how to make a project plan, how to come up with the business strategy, how to come up with the roadmap, what should be the future of this product, when the product is going to die. So this guy would be a perfect bridge to connect with multiple stakeholders, design and management.
So Rohit has a question which says, what are the abilities and orientations required to take up this program? I think we did cover
in the
first part. Generally from like a summary of it is to kind of have that good attitude of solving problems and finding right opportunities, and at the same time having a good understanding of business. You may come from any background, but as long as these two things are there, I think the program is for you. Siddharth has a question which says, how will this program benefit somebody with an interior design background? It's a very specific question.
Yeah, it is a nice question, but let me put this is a specialization agnostic program.
Yeah.
Okay, so for me, I don't care from where have you come.
Okay.
Interior design, excellent. You can apply those interior design tools, techniques, frameworks, learn here and go big bang. It's perhaps it if you think it can be a great opportunity to change the career from interior design to a design management. It's a metamorphosis of that guy.
Interesting. So Namita has a question. Okay, very, very fundamental question. What is the need for a PG in design management? So I think what the way we would interpret is that again, partly the kind of roles, and there are a few other questions also which we saw which were talking about the proper career opportunities as to what will I do in a day-to-day life, or what does a day in life of a design manager looks like. So any thoughts on that? I'm sure you yourself have been in that position, so you would have seen that very closely.
I think when I did my master's in design, that time such kind of course was not there. So I took 20 years to go to that level, you know.
Okay.
Here, in the beginning itself, you are getting those, if I may use the word called capsules, or if I get something which are management related, technology related, strategy related, innovation management related.
Okay.
So it's an early exposure you get, and this is very beneficial for any of the aspirants.
And in terms of roles which they will actually go and do, so because there are a few questions on the career opportunities, so what are the typical job roles or career paths that exist for people?
Right. So I would take this question slightly different.
Well,
in a way that I see, say, 4 to 5 avenues on which you can make your career. Avenue number one, assume that you complete your design management master's or MDes in design management. A, you can start your own startup. It needs courage, guys, but it's very important that you can start your own startup because you have got everything to start with. If I'm a designer, if I'm just taking one example, say I'm a product designer, so I'm taking product design. But I may not be knowing what are the other aspects of economics, microeconomics, social aspects, so on and so forth. So I may not be the right guy. But after MDes in design management, I can start my own startup. Perhaps your diploma project or degree project can be taken as a
startup.
That's number one. Wherein you are entrepreneur. The role is you are entrepreneur. Number two is, I see a very dynamic change, forget about what party and what who is ruling. There are so many government bodies, they are looking out for such kind of a people who understand design and management.
True.
For example, policy. Assume that people who are staying alone, say elderly people who are staying alone, we want to design something for them, some policy to be designed for them. So there is opportunity for design management guy, you know, who understand design and management. Third is, if you are really socially conscious, you can go into social enterprise sector. There are so many people who want design management guys, you know, who can be a design evangelist, who would go there and not only talk about screen design or icon design, but they will talk about fundamentals of how to take design to
and
multiple layers and levels. And the fourth is working in a big corporates or MNCs, wherein the projects are extremely complex. The stakeholders are multi geographically located. So managing the expectations of these guys and managing the design. So it's again that is role, you know, you start as a design manager and eventually go to the ladder. Say you can be, ultimately you can be a CXO or CDO, chief design officer kind of a role. But it depends on how proactive and what capabilities you have got. But I see three or four avenues wherein they can make the career.
So, good, good. You mentioned some very new and interesting areas which otherwise were not available, or there wasn't an opportunity for either only an MBA or only a designer to get into. So I think this opens up a kind of new windows for these graduates. Which sectors do you think has a more affinity? Means I'm sure there is the work happening at across different kind of organization, but which sectors do you think are the most ripe for such kind of professionals?
Sectors, do you mean domains?
Yeah, domains or say industry sector. So whether it's more
If we see fintech,
okay,
is one of the areas wherein definitely there is scope for design management,
okay,
masters. Mm-hmm. Second sector, what I would talk about is telecommunication and overall communication sector.
Communication and media as well.
Yeah, communication and media. Third, even education sector, you know, there are a lot of opportunities.
Mm.
And fourth is healthcare.
Okay.
So, in short, you know, Harshit, I see plethora of opportunities for these guys. You know, it's inappropriate to pick one or two sectors.
Yeah, I mean, in a way, it's like, because it's specialization agnostic, on this side also it is equally sector agnostic.
Right.
So, each and every sector will have some or the other role for
them. So, if I use the T model, you know, it's a horizontal exploration and vertical depth as well.
Depth.
So you get to know design management, economics, social context, innovation. At the same time, you can use all these techniques and tools while you do the project. So it's an appropriate balance of a team model.
Okay. Yeah. So there is this one question by Shubham. What are the prerequisites or experience required for applying to the program? So it's more about the eligibility and all of that. So see, ideally, if you come with some work experience, yes, it does help. You can gain more from the program because you already have been in a context and you know how organizations work and how different processes and functions exist in an organization. But having said that, there is a value for somebody who comes as a fresher as well, because as I mentioned earlier, it's a cohort approach. You'll learn from each other. So people who have some experience will bring in some value. People who are fresh bring in a very fresh perspective. They are not biased. So work experience is preferred, but it's not mandatory in that sense. Yeah. The next is from Siddhi. Is social innovation, entrepreneurship, and the related topics, are they covered in the design management program? So I would first let you talk, because you have taken that module and you know how things work.
Right.
And then I will also kind of elaborate later.
Right. So the question what Siddhi is asking, first let's remove that thought process that whether this is covered or not. Design school is such a place wherein you can pursue your passion in terms of projects.
Okay.
If I'm interested in doing some work for, say, visually impaired people, is it covered? Yes, because I can do that project. Design school, guys, is teaching you different frameworks, processes, methodologies, tools, approaches. Where you want to apply, you can apply in social sector, you can apply in corporates, you can apply in medical science. I might take up a project wherein a school which is there in Leh Ladakh, and they are teaching very basics of that. So is it covered? Yes, it is covered. You need to take that project.
Okay. Yeah, so I think building on what sir said, the very nature of design education and hence of this design management program is that the topic is defined by the student. So there is a larger context, there is a brief, there is a framework, and there are certain basics which needs to be covered. But the what part of it, that whether I take up social entrepreneurship or whether I take healthcare or whether I take some very high-tech consumer appliance, all that is left open for the candidate to choose. And hence, this also goes back to the original philosophy of the program, that here design is the core. and other things are at the periphery. There are nowadays, so we see a lot of other business schools and other management programs who have a input in design, mm-hmm. or they have a elective in design thinking, right, or right, something
right.
like that.
Right, right.
But unlike those programs, here the entire thing and the pedagogy is built like a design program.
Right.
And then there are other aspects which are at the periphery. You are free to choose what you want to kind of mix and match and then make a career out of it.
Right. So just can I add?
Yeah, yeah, please.
We need to be conscious of time.
Yeah, yeah. So I think we have next 5 to 10 minutes to conclude.
Okay. So it's like a concentric circle. So design is a core, which is a very core of your course. Then complementary is management, and peripheral is strategy, innovation, technology, economics. And the glue is how innovatively you attach those.
Interesting. So. Great. I think, we are done with the questions. And thank you, sir. Thanks a lot for all your very, very rich insights. And I hope the session was useful for all the students. And for any further queries, I think there are enough links given on the website where you can just check and reach out to us in case there are any further questions that you may have. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I make the world graphical.
I add value through my products.
I am an animator.
I am a filmmaker. I develop trends.
I transform designs to reality.
I create environments.
I translate stories to furniture.
I design experiences.
I'm an immersive media designer.
I design mobility.
This is not only a design institute.
This is a design lab.
Design.